Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I've just got another Woolworths grocery haul. Today I have a few extra things for Christmas as well, and just obviously also food we're gonna need for the week. I'll bring the other foods out of the fridge soon because it's just a little bit too hot. I haven't got a meal planner as such and probably won't have one structured until like the new year. So I'm just going to like tell you what we're gonna have and tell you what I'm sort of gonna make up for the kids' snacks and just things like that to get us through the school holidays. The first thing I'm just gonna start over here, and I just got some Schweppes lemonade. I did order the other brand, I think it was the Kirks. They didn't have it in stock. Schweppes was on special, so I got that one instead for a substitute. And now I finally got the Coca-Cola I've been waiting for. We got that when it was 30 cans for about $24, something like that. And they're for like just putting in the fridge outside for when we have visitors over Christmas and we might have a bit of a New Year's get together. Just some extra drinks there for people if they come over. I've also got some prune juice here. I usually freeze this when I don't drink at all. I have still got half of one in the freezer, but I haven't ventured down in the Tucker Box freezer to get that. So this was on special for $5. I usually sort of water it down a bit too, so it's not so rich. The kids sometimes have it, but not a lot of it. It's very concentrated. Well, it is 100% juice. I've also got some soda water. We do have a soda stream, but we're running low, and I don't think we're going to go over to Big W anytime over the next week, so I just got some of these. I got 5 bottles of soda water. I also got some free-range eggs here, just 2 cartons of eggs. We went through 2 cartons of eggs last week. I'm not sure how the kids have... Well, I do know. The kids have had eggs every morning for some reason. They've just got a craving for eggs. And I guess when we have a scrambled eggs, we put about 5 eggs in it for the family. I needed more eggs. I still haven't done my baking, which I'm doing my baking video for Christmas this week, which I will film. Okay, I've got some paper plates here because, you know, always need paper plates. And we do use them a lot for barbecues when we have people over. I know, you know, I don't go get my best china out of or anything like that, but I just get the paper plates and the forks and the knives and serviettes, and it's done. So I've got a big packet of these. Those are $5 for 80. They're just so much easier, and I always make sure I've got a stack of them in the cupboard. I've got some of the Royal Gala apples because we're running low on apples and the kids are just going through fruit. So with like the kids are like having a lot of snacks through the day, obviously more, they eat more than what they do at school. I'm not sure how, I think it's more boredom than anything else. So what I'm doing is sort of making up like a fruit platter for them in the afternoon for snacks. I'll have like some apples. I've also got some strawberries and I've got some blueberries, but I've just got them this week. But usually they just have apples, some cheese slices and some crackers, and that's like their afternoon snack. And then I'll give them like a smoothie, like I'll make like a mango smoothie or a banana smoothie as well, maybe about 10-15 minutes after that. But that's basically, they have like a bit of a fruit platter there. So I've got the strawberries and I've got the blueberries for that. I've also got some of the Trust tomatoes. We have got a stall down the road. Our tomatoes are $2 a kilo on the side of the road, but every time we get there, it's in the afternoon and we don't go in the mornings and they're out of stock because everyone's just running to get them. I've got some of the Odd Bunch lemons. They have got a lot of markings on them, but I guess that's why they're the Odd Bunch, but they're pretty firm. These were nearly $4 a bag and just got them for, you know, to put with drinks and things like that. You know, you always need lemons. I'm going to make a cheesecake, so I'm not sure if I'm going to use lemon or like I might put passion fruit. I'm not sure yet. So I've also got some apricots because they're in season, and I've also got some nectarines as well. So they'll have to like ripen up a bit before we can eat them. I've also, here we got some bananas. They're really big ones too, which the kids don't really eat. They sort of waste them, like they can halve a banana there instead of wasting it. Okay, I've got some tartar sauce because we've got 2 4-kilo boxes, I'm pretty sure, of prawns in the freezer for Christmas, Australian prawns, and I'm really looking forward to that. So I've just got some tartar sauce. I've also got some traditional gravy mix because we had no gravy in the house and I thought that was on special. I usually just use the gravy powder and do it all myself, but why not over Christmas? Take the easy way out is what I say. I've also got some baked pretzels because they're always good with a side of a platter or cheese and fruit, and I can do that with the kids you know, in the afternoons when they want a few pickers. I've also got some pure icing sugar because I'm going to be making gingerbread, and I'm going to be doing that this week. That's going to be my baking Christmas video. So I'm really looking forward to that. I will have the kids making them with me. So I've also got some Kleenex toilet paper. This is the 24 rolls. Everything was off the shelf. Like with toilet paper, I put a few things in the cart and it kept saying that they weren't in the area, they weren't available in my store. So usually we just buy like the home brand toilet paper, but we haven't been able to get that for about a month now. So we just got the Kleenex. I just wanted to get a stack of that because we are starting to run a little bit low. So, you know, I don't want to have to get that over Christmas. So we've got that. And I've also just got some potatoes here. So these are good for kids during the day as well. Like if I just make like a cold potato salad the night before and just put it in the fridge with some mayonnaise, I've got fresh parsley, and that's really good. And me and my husband can have that for lunch sometimes with, you know, a bit of chicken or something, or just by itself. So I really like having a stack of potatoes. I can always cut up some potatoes and put them in the air fryer to make some chips for the kids. So I really need potatoes with the kids. So I've always got something to eat there. I've got two bags of carrots because these were on special this week for $1 a bag. So I was pretty happy with that, and they last for ages. So they'll do me for a few weeks there. I've got some raw sugar because we're out of sugar, and we only use this for tea and coffees really, and don't go through too much of it. But you know, I am running low. I will have to do another stockpile shop soon because we are starting to run low on that. So that will be in the new year, I would say. Okay, I've also got some of these short crust tartlet cases here. I bought two packets. What's happened here is I got home and spilt a cup of water over them, and the cardboard on one of them's just soaked, so I've had to take that out. So I'm lucky that we've got them without them being broken, I guess. But this is just another easy way. I'm going to make a cheesecake, and I've got Philadelphia cheese in the fridge still. I think they're about $7 for two packets. And I thought, why not just buy them? They're already cooked up. They're yummy, crunchy. And I'm just going to make a Philadelphia cheese. Probably going to use passion fruit in it. I'm probably going to use passion fruit, yeah. I've got lemon, passion fruit. So I'm just going to make like a basic cheesecake. I'm not making it baked or anything like that. It's just going to be like with the gelatine. You know, there's a condensed milk one. I'm not sure yet if I'm going to do that, but I've got like different ways of making them, and I'm just going to do that. And it's just so much easier to serve them out when someone wants one. They're already done. You've got six in a box, you know, and obviously that's what they look like without the cardboard box on them. So so they're a lot easier, and I can just fill them and they're done. And I've got some spray cream, which I'll show you in a minute, that I'm going to put on top of them. Okay, and I've also got some 8 soft wraps because I'm going to make one night some refried bean enchiladas, no meat, so they're going to be nice. Tonight we're actually having a noodle stir fried chicken again because I've still got some noodles and I've taken out some chicken breast. You know, and other than that, we're just probably just going to have like cold salad and salmon. Okay, with the sandwiches now, with the kids on holidays, I usually give them like sausage rolls. They've got fruits, they've got smoothies, sometimes mini meat pies. They've had some cabana and cheese and things like that. But sandwiches are an easy way to just make them up. And I mean, make up a heap of them. You can even freeze them, but I've been starting to like just make up a big plate of sandwiches, cut them into triangles or little squares. And you know, you can make Vegemite cheese, jam, ham, whatever, a mixture of them. And just make a stack of them, put them in the fridge for the day and let the kids just have them, you know, and that's what they have. And also with that, sometimes I'll do that the night before or that morning. And also while I'm making up the sandwiches, I'll make up a big drink for them. Now I got these from Aldi about a year ago. I think I paid about $3.50 for them. They're like an esky, really, an esky drink. They keep the drinks really cold. I keep them in the fridge, but and they'll even stay colder. And I just fill them up with water, and they just put their own reusable like paper straw in there, and then I throw the paper straw out. So, you know, and they sort of can have that all day and put it back in the fridge. So I just always fill that up with water for them, and that's in the fridge. Like I'll do that the night before, maybe put them in the fridge, They've got their drinks ready, make a stack of sandwiches, and they've already got that organized. They've got breakfast, which is just like cereal. We'll have cereal. Sometimes my youngest will have like a smoothie. I'll just have some granola and yogurt. So I've sort of, you know, there's not so much structure with it over the holidays as such. It's just trying to make it a little bit easier. But sandwiches are just, I'm finding it just so much easier, and I don't have to cook all the time. When I make sausage rolls and things like that, I've got to put the stove on all the time, or the air fryer, and it just gets so hot. All right, so I've also got some cling wrap and some aluminium foil. You know, we're running low on that, and I'll probably need some of that for like the little turkey that I'm going to put in the oven. I've also got some of the Strike disinfectant wipes. There are 100 here. They're really cheap. They're under $4, and they last me about 6 months. I only use them, you know, in the toilets and things like that, but they're just handy to have. I've just grabbed a box of the Cousins Bliss. I haven't tried this one before, and I haven't used powder in my washing machine in such a long time. I usually use liquid. I've still got like Dynamo left and things like that, but I just got a box of this. I think it was about $6, reduced from $8, and I thought this is going to be a lot, like just keep this in the cupboard for when I put on towels or if I run low on something. So, you know, just as a backup there. And I've also got some of the Strike bleach toilet gel. I use that in the toilet. I even use it like in the grout in the shower, because it's got that nozzle on it where you can squirt it out and around like the edges of the bath and things like that. So I just find that bleach a lot easier for me than using the the pour-in liquid as such. These are a really good price. I think they're about $3.50 a packet. They're chalk dipped, 10 pack. They're cheap as. I was gonna buy a couple of boxes of them and just chuck them in the deep freeze or the big tucker box freezer. But, you know, they're a great price. I just got some of the plain vanilla ice cream because the big one I bought about 3 weeks ago hasn't lasted the 4 liters. It's gone. So just got some of the vanilla one to put with some plum pudding or custard or whatever dessert we're going to have. Or the kids might just want some hundreds and thousands on it. Or we just use it for smoothies. Okay, I've also got some butter because I got a backup thing of butter. I know sometimes things don't work out, especially when I'm baking, and they might end up in the bin if they're burnt. And I thought I better buy some more butter just in case, just to have. I have got one in the freezer that I've got in there. I've also got a big block as well. But, you know, just wanted a little bit more just in case. I've got some dips. So I've got gherkin. This one's nice. I've got spicy capsicum. And I also got sour cream and chives. But I am going to make that traditional French onion one with the French onion soup mix and the sour cream when I get some more sour cream next week, because I really like that French onion dip. It's just easy, and you can make it as like strong or weak as you want by putting less or more of the soup powder in there. Okay, milks. Now I got myself a trim. I've also got some light milk, and I've also got some full cream milk. All up, we got 17 liters of milk this week. The kids are just drinking it like crazy. We're having a few smoothies a day. Everyone in my house is home. So husband's home, I'm home, the kids are home. So yeah, we've got a lot of milk here. Obviously these ones are only gonna last till the 20th, 27th, the 28th. The rest is in the fridge outside. But yeah, 17 liters of milk is what we have bought this week. Okay, now sausages. Now these, the kids are liking these, and I thought it was a good idea to buy another packet of them. I cook all these up at once and put them in the fridge, and they've got something for a few days for lunch. I don't really eat them. I mean, we'll have them sometimes for a dinner or something, but I just leave them for the kids, and they just have them with, just with bread and sauce, you know, and or they can have it with a bit of salad or tomato that I'll make on the side for them. Just make them, put them in the fridge, and they're cold. They can just eat them when they want to, and they can get them out of the fridge themselves. So I find that one an easy go-to when you've got kids on school holidays for 8 weeks. Okay, I've got some of this brandy custard because I really like this, and it's just something we buy at Christmas time. This was on special, so I got it this week. And I wanted to get it this week in case next week they don't have it. So yeah, that's just basically for our plum pudding. Now I got some whipped cream because that's the one I'm going to put on top of the cheesecake little cases. So just put a little bit of cream on top when I'm serving them out. And I find it lasts ages. I did try and get the light one, but they didn't have it in stock. So I thought, it doesn't matter anyway. And I also got some vanilla flavored yogurt. This is just for for me. I haven't made my Easy Yo up. I'm going to do it. But I just got the cheap one. I just put some granola or toasted muesli on that in the mornings. It's just easier, I find, and it's easier than me making like porridge and things like that. Sometimes I'll have Weet-Bix, but I'll usually just grab that. Now, I've got some yogurts this week. As you can see, lots of yogurts. Okay, so obviously we've got 4 strawberries. I ordered blueberry, but they didn't have any in stock, so just banana and strawberry there. For the kids, and I got them something as a little treat here. This is the Mrs. Claus gingerbread yogurt. I'm not sure what that is going to taste like. I'm not sure if they're even going to like it, so I might just make them have like a taste of each other's first before they ruin 2 of them. And also I got these Santa's milk and cookies. I just thought they were Christmassy. They're cute as a treat. And yeah, so I just grabbed them for them. That's our groceries for the week. It cost $216 this week. They did substitute me a few things. So with the meals, I'm probably just going to make like more of like a potato bacon bacon this week. We're going to have fried enchiladas and beans. I'm going to make a stack of muesli slices this week, so it's just easy to grab if we want to go out instead of buying them, because we've you know, eaten so many muesli bars lately. So I just thought I'd make some. And other than that, this week I'll be doing the Christmas baking, and I'll also bring out a video on what we are getting the kids for Christmas. That will be another video as well. And other than that, there'll be probably just a few more grocery hauls coming up to Christmas, and like the smaller hauls that I'll just do a pickup or run into Aldi and get. Do have to go to Aldi and get some meat. So it was $216, but that's no meat except for the sausages that I've just shown you. So I'll probably go there and get some like Colby cheeses and things like that, because they've got some nice things out at the moment, Aldi, and especially for like platters. So yeah, so basically that's our shop for the week, $216 at Woolworths. I hope you enjoy this video. Thanks everyone for watching, and I'll see you next time. Thanks everyone. Bye.